Last class we discussed about importance of performance analysis. But the performance analysis is a triangle story: the power output, speed, fuel consumption. These three are important parameters according to the the customer requirement, customer need. We will give the importance to the performance analysis. At present, customer requirement: the power output, speed, not specific fuel consumption. 20 years back, the customer requirement: power output and fuel consumption, not speed. So year wise, the decades are changing, the importance parameters are changing. So to measure the performance analysis, first we have to calculate the indicated power, brake power, friction. These three we want to measure for measurement of the performance analysis: indicated power, brake power, friction power. If we measure these three powers, then we can calculate the different efficiencies and heat balance sheets, everything we can do. But first we want to measure the indicated power, brake power and friction power. Different methods we are using. First move to the indicated power means the actual conversion of chemical energy to the heat energy. The actual indicated power means the power developed in the cylinder. Means in the cylinder what we are developing, we are converting chemical energy to the heat energy. That we want to calculate. That one we can calculate by using the indicator diagram or by adding two measuring quantities like brake power and friction power. We can calculate. Indicator diagram is generally in R&D labs only we are doing that indicator diagram base. This measurement of the brake power and friction power we can calculate in a normal condition. There is no issue. So if indicator diagram based calculation of the indicated power means plan, we are called plan. Indicated mean effective pressure multiplied by the length of the stroke and area of the cylinder and number of power strokes. That's a plan. This remaining all extra, that K, if multi-cylinder engine, then number of cylinders. And 1000, if indicated mean effective pressure in Newton per meter square, then we want to convert into kilonewtons. Why? Because our output in kilowatts. Then divided by 1000. If speed in RPS, this 60 is not required because kilojoules per second we want output, but speed generally we are measuring in RPM. So for that purpose, divided by 60. That's all. This N, small N, is not RPM, number of power strokes. The number of power strokes, if two stroke engine, speed equal to number of, small N equal to capital N. Why? Because in two stroke, every revolution of the crankshaft, we are producing one power stroke. But in four stroke, every two revolutions of the crankshaft, we are producing one power stroke. That's all. And the mean effective pressure, first we want to determine. By using the indicator diagram, we are calculating mean effective pressure. Theoretically, what is the definition? Means it is a hypothetical pressure acting on the piston from piston expansion stroke, means starting to ending. It is an average pressure acting on the piston in the expansion. Starting of the expansion, highest peak pressure is there. At the end of the expansion, the nominal pressure is there, means we above the ambient. So average mean effective pressure acting on the piston we are calculating. Theoretically, work output by swept volume. Swept volume, we know, is the piston, whatever the stroke, piston movement, pi by 4 d square into L, diameter, cross-sectional diameter, and length of the stroke, you will get the swept volume, not total volume. Why? Because clearance volume also is coming to the picture for total volume. Next, by using indicator diagram, how we are calculating is, area of the indicator diagram divided by length of the indicator diagram to spring constant, simply. Area of the indicated diagram divided by length of the indicated diagram into spring constant. Generally, spring constant, that units, we have to follow the units. Okay, this is the basic method. So, one small problem we will solve, then we will get the clear idea about how to calculate the indicated power. The following observations has been made from the test of a four-cylinder, as I mentioned, a four-cylinder two-stroke petrol engine. So, small n equal to capital N. Why? Because number of revolution equal to number of power strokes. Two stroke every revolution we are getting the power stroke. One important point. Second, how many cylinders are there? The number of cylinders are 4. So 2 points are mentioned. Next, diameter of the cylinder 10 centimeter. We convert into meters. Diameter is there. Then you can determine the area pi by 4 d square. Okay. Next, stroke length is 15 centimeter. The stroke length is 15 centimeter. Convert into meters. So diameter into stroke length, you will get the so 12. Next, speed 1600 rpm. Okay, everything is there. Only except mean effective pressure, everything is available. Next, for determination of the mean effective pressure, what they given? Area of the indicator diagram 5.5 centimeter square. The area of the indicator diagram 5.5 centimeter square and length of the indicator diagram 55 mm. Area of the indicator diagram they given 5.5 centimeter square. Length of the indicator diagram they given 55 mm. So convert into centimeters. Spring constant 3.5 bar divided by centimeters. So for calculation of the mean effective pressure, everything you maintain centimeter. Then final output you will get in bars, convert into Newton per meter square divided by 10 power 5. Then you will get to convert into Newton per meter square and you do the your work. Determine the indicated power of the engine. That's all. Everything is given in the problem. You can see diameter 0.1 meter, length 0.15 meter, number of cylinders 4. RPM, speed 1600, so small n equal to capital N, number of power strokes equal to number of speed. Next, area of the indicator diagram 5.5 centimeter square, length of the indicator diagram 5.5 centimeter, spring constant 3.5 bar per centimeter. Then mean effective pressure, area of the indicator diagram 5.5 into spring constant 3.5 divided by length of the indicator diagram 5.5, you will get 3.5 bar. Convert into Newton per meter square. Then 3.5 into 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. So we determine the mean effective pressure. Indicated mean effective pressure. Then what is the indicated power? The equation of the indicated power is Plan, indicator mean effective pressure into length of the stroke, area of the cylinder, and number of power strokes into number of cylinders divided by 1000 into 60. 3.5 into 10 power 5 is the indicated mean effective pressure. Pi by 4 d square, diameter is 0.1 meter square into L, length of the stroke is 0.15 and number of power strokes 1600 and number of cylinders are 4 divided by 60,000. Then indicated power equal to calculate, finally we will get 43.98 kilowatt. So simplest method, and the first method based on the indicator diagram. This is the method. Next part, next indicated power measurement we discuss. Next move to the brake power. In brake power, how we are determining the brake power? Generally, in indicated power, what is the heat energy developed in the engine? Out of that heat energy, how much is converted as a mechanical energy? Means some of the heat energy last as a we can use to overcome the internal friction. Why? Because heat energy developed while piston is moving means internal friction is generated between the piston rings and cylinder bore, and inertia of the moving parts. To overcome that, some energy is lost. After losing of the energy, whatever the actual energy ready to use available means rotation of the shaft, that energy is called brake power. The energy available at crankshaft, the rotation energy, the net power available at the shaft is known as brake power. It is denoted by BP, no doubt. How we can measure the brake power? Generally, brake power we are measuring to measure by the torque and the angular speed. Torque multiplied by the angular speed, we can get the brake power output. So, how we can measure the brake power output means the angular speed we can measure by the tachometer, maybe contact, non-contact type, we can measure the angular speed of the crankshaft. Torque we can measure by using dynamometers. The device which is used for measure the torque is called dynamometer. The dynamometers are two types. One is power absorption dynamometer, second one transmission dynamometer. Absorption dynamometer means whatever the power it is measuring, that power it is absorbing itself. The power is absorbing itself. By absorbing the power, it is measuring the torque generated by the crankshaft. The second one, so it will generate that absorption of power, how it will dissipate means by dissipating the heat energy. So absorption dynamometers, so cooling system is required for absorption dynamometer, otherwise it will create burning of the brakes, so many problems issues will come. But absorption dynamometer means it is absorbing the power, whatever the power we are measuring. Transmission dynamometer, just it will transmit the power. Generally, transmission dynamometer we are using in the manufacturing industry where the engines are developing. At that time, continuation operation of the measurement of the output is required. So, for that purpose, there we are using transmission dynamometer. Generally, performance analysis labs, testing labs, general testing labs contains absorption dynamometer because simple to measure. And at a particular instant, particular speed, particular load only we are measuring, not continuation operation. So, absorption dynamometers commonly we are using in our labs. I think in our lab also contains this rope drum and pruning brake, mechanical eddy current, all types of the dynamometer, hydraulic dynamometers we have. So, some of the absorption dynamometers are pruning brake, rope brake, hydraulic dynamometer and eddy current dynamometer like that. First, we move to the pruning brake. You can see the pruning brake dynamometer, the flywheel is connected to the crankshaft. The flywheel rotation is holded by the wooden blocks. That wooden blocks are tightly joined by the spring with the spring tension against the brakes and with the bolt and nut joint. This that arm, torque arm, whatever the torque arm is there, the torque arm one more end is connected to the weight by rope connection, some weight we counterweight we are connecting. So, I want to measure the power developed by the this crankshaft. We are stopping the flywheel rotation. For stopping the flywheel rotation, how much weight is required, that we are measuring instant at particular instant. Then after immediately we are opening the weights, otherwise engine will stop. So simplest method. So by the frictional operation, the wooden brake and the flywheel drum, by frictional operation only we are stopping the rotations, angular rotation of the flywheel in pruning brake. How much load is required, that is important. So, frictional operation, so cooling facility is required for flywheel. If we are not providing cooling facility, maybe burning of the wooden brakes may take place. That's why we placed wooden brakes. If metal brakes we are placing, means frictional welding will take place. If more friction is generated. So, instead of that, that's why we are placing the wooden brakes. So burning of the brakes will come into the picture. Next, how we are measuring the brake power by using the Prony brake system is generally brake power 2 pi NT by 60,000. 60,000 I already mentioned. If torque in Newton per Newton meter, then only this 1000 will come. Kilo Newton meter, this 1000 is not coming. If speed in RPM, then 60 is coming. If speed in RPS, there is no 60. So brake power equal to 2 pi NT. The brake power is 2 pi NT. So torque, here torque, how we are calculating is length of the arm, this length of the arm, and how much load you are acting. So Newton meter, load, how much load is applied for stop the rotation speed of the flywheel, the W, into what is the length of the arm. Generally Prony brake diameter, like that they are giving. So Prony brake diameter they are giving is length of the arm, diameter by 2 we are taking the length of the arm. In the problem they are giving directly length of the arm, you take L directly. So 2 pi N WL by 60,000 in kilowatt, finally you are getting the brake power. This 60,000 I already mentioned, this is not important, 2 pi N WL only important. This W in Newtons, then only 1000 will come. This speed in RPM, then only 60 will come. And here we are speed we are considering, we are not considering the power source. Why? Because indicator of that heat to the power, that chemical energy to the heat, their number of power strokes are required. But here in crankshaft rotation is coming, that rotational torque only we are measuring, so directly we are taking the speed. So brake power is equal to 2 pi N WL by 60,000. Next, row brake. Next, exhaustion dynamometer. Upon this row brake and Prony brake, you will get end examination problems majorityly on brake power. Maximum based on these two only, you will get the problems. So in a Prony brake, in a row brake, you see, in row brake also flywheel crankshaft is connected to the flywheel, but flywheel wound by the thread, two or three rounds wound by the thread. One end connected to the spring balance, another end connected to the counterweight. Flywheel always we are providing the cooling facility, means just water supply we are doing. While we are applying load for measurement of the torque generated by the shaft, while you applied the load, then counterbalance spring reading also getting some spring reading. At which point we are stopping, entire rotation speed we are stopping, at that condition W, you can note down the W value and you can note down the spring constant value. Then you substitute the equation pi d n into W minus S. This is the spring load, this is the W. Maintain in Newtons. This is the diameter of the flywheel. Generally, diameter of the flywheel, if they are not given rope diameter, no need to consider rope diameter. If they provided rope diameter, means this diameter of the flywheel means flywheel diameter plus rope thickness. What is the rope thickness? Into 2. 2 into rope thickness. Because both sides rope will come. So 2 into rope thickness also you have to consider for diameter of the rope. Generally directly they are given a diameter of the drum only, not given flywheel only, not given the rope thickness. Means you can consider pi d n W minus S divided by 60,000. This load in Newtons, then only 1000. Speed in RPM, then only 60. Equation of brake power is pi d n into W minus S. So these are the two methods. These two methods are general methods. Exact values you will not get, but these are the general methods for measurement of the brake power. In all, majority of the testing laboratories are maintaining these two experiments, two equipments for measurement of any type of engine. Maybe two-stroke engine, maybe four-stroke engine, maybe SI engine, maybe CI engine. So for measurement of the brake power means the power generated at the shaft. We want to measure the power output. For that measurement, we are using absorption dynamometer, general testing labs. The standard absorption dynamometers are, one is Prony brake, second one is the row break dynamometers. So next class, remaining absorption and transmission dynamometers we discuss.